Hello, Cloud Gurus, and welcome to GCP This Month for February 2020. I'm your host, Mattias Andersson, and this month we'll cover a number of enhancements to GKE, as well as some things that improve running Microsoft workloads on GCP, and sometimes both at the same time. We'll also look at Dataflow, Dialogflow, and GPUs, oh my, plus a bunch of compute engine releases. So let's get right to it. Google's managed service for Microsoft Active Directory is now generally available. You can let Google run and completely manage actual Microsoft AD servers for you. A lot of organizations use Microsoft Active Directory, so this can smooth their migrations to GCP and reduce their ops burden. Cloud SQL for SQL Server is now completely out of beta globally. This means that you can have Google manage your Microsoft SQL Server 2017 database servers for you with a 99.95% uptime SLA. Dataflow monitoring has gotten much better now that it includes charts and alerts for both CPU utilization and element throughput. The best thing is that these are broken down for each step of your pipeline. You can then zoom into interesting parts of the timeline to help diagnose issues. Now you have even more reason to go with the flow, right? This next update is pretty intense. The Dialogflow Mega Agent now supports up to 20,000 intents. Dialogflow is a platform for building chatbots and interactive voice responses, and it's what powers Google's Contact Center AI product. Now that it can handle 10 times as many intents as before, your virtual agent can be set up to guide your users through tons more situations. Dialogflow has also gotten some improvements to help you develop better agents more reliably. In case you already use NVIDIA T4 GPUs, or you were maybe considering them for your AI or 3D workloads, you should know that Google has just slashed their prices more than 60% across the board. These GPUs offer incredible value, and a benchmark run on ML Engine showed these T4s costing less than half as much as the next closest GPU type. Google's new N2D machine type family, based on AMD EPYC processors, is now in beta. These are general-purpose instances and offer all the same compute engine features as the Intel-based N2 instances, but at a lower price and with higher performance. N2Ds are available right now in US Central 1, Asia Southeast 1, and Europe West 4. Google has released improvements to how you can manage sole tenant nodes, such as you might need for stringent compliance or licensing requirements. If you need to minimize your physical core usage because of Windows licensing requirements, you'll appreciate the new support for live migration within a fixed node group. And if you're auto-scaling VMs, you'll have new auto-scaling support to add or remove sole tenant nodes as needed. Finally, you can now migrate VMs into and out of sole tenancy by stopping them, updating their node affinity, and restarting them. Sadly, there's no live migration support for that last case, but it's still much better than having to recreate them from scratch. Historically, managed instance groups, or MIGs, have only been a good match for stateless workloads, where creating and destroying instances is no big deal. But now, Google has gone into beta with stateful MIGs, in which instances keep all of their persistent disk and metadata the same. This can be great for things like database nodes, or those stateful legacy applications that I'm sure you'll get around to replacing any day now, right? Config Connector is a new GKE plugin that can let you manage GCP resources through Kubernetes, including RBAC and events. How Config Connector works is that it provides a collection of Kubernetes custom resource definitions and controllers for them. Then those will create and update your Google Cloud resources when you configure and apply custom objects to your cluster. Application Manager, another new enhancement to basic GKE, offers an opinionated and simple way to set up your app with a GitOps-based CI/CD flow that follows many of Google's best practices. It uses tools like Customize internally, and because it is easily scriptable, you can call it from build tools like Cloud Build or Jenkins. Check it out! But now, let's take a look at this month's GCP Gems. So, have you heard the news? Well, probably not, which is why you're watching this video, right? Well, Stackdriver is dead! Long live Stackdriver! Okay, this might seem a bit grim at first, but let me explain. Back in 2014, Google acquired the Stackdriver company and product. Ever since then, they've been doing two things. One, adding significant new products and functionality to the Stackdriver family, and two, integrating more and more of the Stackdriver console directly into the normal GCP console. Well, now that ends. All of the Stackdriver functionality remains, but every last bit of it has finally been fully integrated into the normal GCP console. And the Stackdriver brand is being, well, retired might be a good term, I guess. So let's take a look at what this means for terminology. Stackdriver logging is known as cloud logging. This change happened a while ago, but it's where we start. Stackdriver monitoring is now cloud monitoring. Stackdriver trace is now cloud trace. Stackdriver debugger is now, well, you get the picture, right? Pretty much just replace Stackdriver with cloud. But wait, there's more! Not only is cloud monitoring now completely integrated into the Google Cloud Console, it also gets some very nice upgrades. For one, metrics will now be retained for 2 full years, meaning you can compare much further back when investigating issues. And second, metrics will now be written at up to a 10-second granularity, meaning you can get quicker and more detailed information. And that's not all! There's also a new API for creating and managing dashboards, alerts routing through PubSub, and workspaces that let you monitor and control hundreds of GCP projects all together. Follow our link to the blog post to check out all the details. Google has just released into beta support for running Windows Server containers on GKE, even in the same cluster as your Linux containers. Now, such a cluster will need to have a node pool for Windows Server nodes in addition to one for Linux nodes, but this setup can reduce your Windows Server's licensing costs by running multiple Windows container applications on each Windows Server node. Even with Windows Server nodes and containers in your cluster, GKE still supports things like node auto upgrades, private clusters, and regional clusters. And more Windows specifically, it also supports group managed service accounts and the ability to select the Microsoft servicing channel that works best for you. In their announcement, Google also highlights some GCP partnerships with companies that support CI/CD container management of Windows-based workloads on GKE, including CircleCI, CloudBees, and GitLab. There's definitely value here for organizations that have containerizable Windows Server workloads. So what do you think? Are Windows and GKE better together? How about Cloud SQL and Microsoft SQL Server? Stackdriver and the GCP console? All of these are great, but it is my admittedly biased opinion that the best better together story is still A Cloud Guru and Linux Academy joining forces. And one of the upcoming benefits of this is that you'll see more Google Cloud news brought to you by the talented training architects from both original organizations. So be sure to keep tuning in. Finally, we have our GCP Guru of the Month. This month's winner is Adarsh Prasad, a senior cloud DBA based in Singapore. Congratulations! We'll be sending you some awesome swag, including a snazzy A Cloud Guru t-shirt, cool stickers, and a hand-signed card. And all the rest of you should check out this month's question available at the link below. And remember, we choose the best response, not just the first one, so you do all have a chance. Well, that's all for this month's episode. I look forward to seeing many of you in person at Google Cloud Next 2020 in San Francisco in April. If you see me or any of the other gurus attending, be sure to flag us down and say hi. We love to connect with our students like that. Also, just a heads up that the session guide is now posted, so don't forget to plan your time in advance so you get the most out of the event. And until our next episode of GCP this month, keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus!